Hey, this is the Woo Kill John. That is my disc tray. Here's the game. Put it in. You load it up. Oh, I got some Airhead Extreme also. Probably get seasick. Whoa, I just hit my camera. That's probably gonna sound awesome. Okay, so now... How's the knife in that game, Chair? That's cool, that's cool. Yeah, that's my phone. I'll do Darius. That's DJ.
Fuck yeah.
Yeah, that's exactly how you do it. Shit, I need something to hold my fucking... I'm gonna use a tissue box. Basically. Hey, one second, I'll be back. Okay, yeah, when you do the menu... Well, I'll just do it like this. You'll see, like, your blood and stuff. And all you do is you hit up on the D-pad, and it changes it, and it says unknown command. You go down, press Y, and it gives you all the guns. It does that. You go RB, LB, and then you just click on your joystick, and it does that. So, you know they will. And then now you're invincible, they can hit you all you want. And you have all the weapons you want. You go down, with this you hit down, then A, and then now you can fly. Like all you want, and then all you do is you hit A again, and it drops you, and then when you click your joystick, it exits you out of the menu. So basically, your right joystick exits you out of the menu. And then to, like, do slow-mo, you just go up and over to the right, and then super slow-mo is this. To speed it up, it's that, and then A is normal. And that's why you'll see me do this a lot when I get out of my menus. You go up, up, and then I just go X, A, B, and then you go up, down, which takes you to MGD2, and then you just hit up, that makes you run fast. The A that I hit makes you jump higher, not this high, it jumps like a little bit higher. X does unlimited ammo, and B does gravity, which makes you jump like they're really super high. And so, as you can see, my, hold on. My ammo counter. Here, I'll get some more you can see. There you go. So yeah, that's it. And then, to change this, you go up, up to MGD1, and you hit the... L bumper takes it away, then right bumper brings up the co-op scoring, or you hit it again and bring back that. And so it's really easy to get used to the like the basics that everybody wants, which anywhere you go, you just go like through these menus, and then you can exit back. Like when you click it, it exits you one. So if you go here, you exit one, it takes you to the mod menu, you go back down, exit, and to go back to the very main menu, you go back to main. So when you hit down, in binds, you hit A, and then now you can fly. And hit A, and you're back down again. Hit X, and no target is on, so now they won't go after you. And then to turn no target back on again, you just press X again, and now they'll come after you. To press B is UFO mode, so you could fly, like this. And so basically that's it. And I already have a video on how to hot swap, but I could show you how to do that. Which, hot swapping, you take your whole Xbox apart. And with your CD drive cover off, it will look like this. Which, this is from my old Xbox. And you'll have to take the sticker off, because there's this little like plastic cover on some of them. They don't have the sticker over it. It's just like the a metal circle like this. Like this metal circle. And it'll be over the where these are, which it looks like this. And so basically this will be inside there. And that's what spins around, and some of them have a magnet on here, and some of them are just metal, and the magnet is actually on the CD drive, which has a little motor that spins. And so, basically, you have to get this off, and you have to have that little, like this little case, so then when you do hot swap over here, because basically you'll have your Xbox lane on its belly, and then you'll open your drive, and then you will take your modded disc, which you have to use a dual layer DVD, which that's my first one, which are basic mods, and this is the one that I have right now, which all you do is you'll put it in the drive once you already have your main one on, like, but this is how you'll do it. Like, you put in your Call of Duty and then you'll close it. And then you go up to where it says, like, game library. You'll hit A. You'll press A on that. Go down to, like, where it'll have, like, since I already have it saved to my hard drive, they'll be able to, like, it'll say, like, save to hard drive or copy or whatever. And basically, you'll just have it highlighted. And then while the disc is spinning, you take that disc off, and you put the modded disc on, and you put this back on, because it's a magnet, which will actually help the CD to spin fast enough rate, because if it doesn't, it'll just think it's a DVD, and the needle spins. And like, when you re-put the mod disc on, you have to spin it a little bit to help once you put the magnet on it. And then once it's spinning, then you burn it to your hard drive, which will burn the mod disc to your hard drive. And once that's done, then basically you take the mod disc out, which you just hit like this, and this cover will be off and all that, because your Xbox will be open. And basically you just take the mod disc off, put the real disc in, close it, and then just play from hard drive, and then you're good. But when you put your Xbox tray back on, make sure you put this metal thing back in here. And with the newer ones that have the sticker over the little circle plastic inside, or metal, sometimes the sticker will be messed up, like as you can see this little ridge. So you can just retape it over, or whatever works. And do not try to pull this through, because like the only way this can come out is when it's in there, is to take the back out, because then if you damage this, then you're really screwed. You don't have to buy like a new Xbox or Xbox DVD tray. So that's it. Hope you enjoyed this little tut on how to hot swap, because I know I have another one out there. It's more detailed with my Xbox actually apart and all that, but that's it. Later.